Okay, students, in the last class now we have discussed about the order of reaction and even what are the types of the order of a reaction. We discussed about the first order reaction, second order reaction, third order reaction, even the zero order reaction, as well as the fractional order of a reaction. So accordingly we know the definitions about what are the order of reactions. Now there will be some numericals based on what no unit of the rate constant. We can find what is the type of the order of reaction. We have discussed in the previous class about the units of the rate constant K. For unit of the rate constant for the zero order reaction, that is different. For first order reaction, that is different. For second order reaction, it is different. Even third order reaction also, it is different. The unit of the rate constant of the different orders are different only. The unit of the rate constant of a reaction depending upon the order of the reaction. The unit of the rate constant is not same for all the type of the order of reactions. For first order, the unit of the rate constant is different. For second order, the unit of the rate constant is different. Okay, just based on that, you know, there will be some multiple choice, or there will be some questions based on the order of reactions. We can find. Just I am giving you some examples here. You see this, what is called? Identify the order of reaction. Identify order of the reaction. Suppose there are some examples given here. One example, 3.5 into 10 to the power minus 5, and 2.6 into 10 to the power minus 5 liter per mole per second, and 5.6 into 10 to the power minus 4 mole per liter per second. Can you find what is the order of reaction for these values of the rate constant? The value of K is given here. K is equal to this much. Here though, the K is equal to 2.6 into 10 to the power minus 5, and here K is equal to 5.6 into 10 to the power minus 4. Respective units also given here. Then what is that order of the reaction? Can you tell me now? Now accordingly, first one, you know that what is that unit of the rate constant only per second given. Unit of the rate constant only per second given means what is the order of the reaction? Now this reaction follows what, you know, that first order. It follows a first order. You know how it is a first order? You know that that is a mole to the power 1 minus n and liter to the power n minus 1 per second. Following, if the value of n is 1, means 1 minus 1 0, 1 minus 1 0, here also 1 minus 1 0, then unit only for the first order, that is per second. Here the unit of the rate constant given, that is per second, means then it follows the first order kinetics. And similarly, the unit of the rate constant given here, what is it? Per mole liter per second it is, or liter per mole per second it is. If it is a second order, can you tell me? If it is a second order, means mole inverse minus 1, that is liter inverse plus 1, that is liter to the power 1, mole to the power minus 1, mole to the power minus 1, liter to the power plus 1, and the per second is the unit. Therefore here, no, this will be following which one, can you tell me? That is second order kinetics. Second order kinetics. Following, can you tell me similarly this one, what is the order of the reaction by knowing the value of the rate constant? Values of the rate constant K given here, then it follows which order kinetics? Can you tell me now? If it is a zero order, then you can take now value of 1 minus 0 and value of n is equal to 0. If you take, then 1 minus 0 is equal to mole to the power 1 only. Liter to the power 0 means per liter only per second. Mole per liter per second means then it follows that zero order kinetics. Okay, we should have this knowledge. We should have this basic idea. Based on the units of the rate constant, it is possible to predict what is the type of the order of reaction. How it is first order based on the unit of the rate constant, how it is second order based on the unit of the rate constant, how it is zero order based on the unit of the rate constant. Like this, so there are some examples will be asked in the competitive examination. So at the same time, what is the order of the reaction is based on the unit of the rate constant, we can predict. So this is one of the type of what, no, finding the order of reaction by knowing what, no, the units of the rate constant. Okay, now we'll move towards one more example. Another one it is. Okay, the question will be given like this. For a reaction, A plus B gives rise to P. That is products only. A plus B gives the products. The rate law is. Rate law is there. Given by what? No, rate is equal to K into molar concentration of A to the power plus of and B to the power 2 only. Is it not? Then how to find the order of the reaction? What is the order of reaction? The question will be like this. Usually, in order to find the order of the reaction, we must know the rate equation. We must know the rate equation for the reaction. Rate equation is given only. That rate law expression is given. By knowing the rate law expression or rate equation, it is possible to find the order of the reaction. For this reaction, the overall order, according to the definition of the order, you know, what is the order of reaction? Order of reaction is sum of the powers. Sum of the powers of the concentration of reactants present in the experimentally determined rate equation for the reaction. That is called order of the reaction only. Then what is order? That is 1 by 2 plus 2 only. 1 by 2 plus 2 only. Can you tell me now what is the overall order of the reaction? On simplification, we get what are that? 2. 5 by 2 or 5 by 2, that is equal to 2.5. It is one of the example for one fractional order reaction. For any kind of the fractional order, usually the rate equation or rate law expression is given. Based on the rate law expression, it is possible to find the order of the reaction. Usually this kind of the questions appear based on the fractional order. It is fractional order. Okay, now we'll take one more example regarding what, no, this one, order of the reaction. You see that the conversion of reactant X to Y follows second order kinetics. If the concentration of X is increased 3 times, how will it affect the rate of formation of Y? Means how many times rate of reaction increases? We should know that, no? What is it? Conversion of X to Y follows what? Second order kinetics. Second order kinetics. Can you tell me what is the rate equation for the reaction? R is equal to K into molar concentration of X to the power 2 only. Molar concentration of X to the power 2. But that X, it is a reactant only. According to the law of mass action, we can write, no, the rate law expression. This follows second order kinetics, means K is equal to, R is equal to K into molar concentration of X to the power 2. Now can you tell me, if concentration of X is increased 3 times, concentration of X increased by 3 times means how will it affect the rate of formation of Y? Means how many times rate of reaction increases? This is what our question. So now you tell me R is equal to K into, then what is the value of X? Means how many times the concentration of reactant, no, X increased? That is what, no, concentration of X increased by 3 times. That is what, no, 3X square only. Can you tell me now R is equal to K into 9X square? Means the rate of formation of Y is increased by 9 times. Rate of reaction increased by how many times? 9 times by increasing the concentration of reactant. Usually this concentration of reactant is one of the factor on which rate of reaction depends. Rate of reaction depends on the concentration of reactant, okay? As concentration of reactant increases, the rate usually increase only. Rate of formation, how will it affect the rate of formation of Y? Means rate of formation of Y increased by 9 times. That is the meaning. Rate of reaction increased by 9 times. So like this, no, there are many number of the examples will be asked based on what, no, the rate of the reaction, or it may be order of the reaction. We have to understand first of all carefully numericals based on what, no, this order of the reaction. Okay. This is one of the important concept in the chemical kinetics. What is called a integrated rate equation. What is this integrated rate equation? You know, dependence of concentration of reactant. Dependence of rate on the concentration of reactant is called a differential rate equation. Is called what? Differential rate equation. Is called what? Differential rate equation. Differential rate equation. We must know this term. What is it? Differential rate equation. What is a differential rate equation? You know, dependence of a concentration, that is a dependence of rate on concentration of reactant. The dependence of rate on the concentration of reactant is called what? Differential rate equation. Following, the differential rate equation is given by what? That is instantaneous rate only. You know what is that instantaneous rate? Instantaneous means it is a rate of reaction at a particular interval of time, at a particular time interval. What is that rate of reaction? That is called what? Instantaneous rate. Is it not? Instantaneous rate means the rate of reaction is the rate of reaction at a particular time interval. That is called what? Instantaneous rate. But instantaneous rate is not easy. It is not convenient to determine what? No, the differential rate means in order to determine the rate of reaction and then what is that order of the reaction, it is little bit difficult because instantaneous rate is measured by, that is now plotting a graph of concentration versus time, in which now we have to take the slope of the tangent. So this method is not convenient to determine what? No, rate law, or it may be rate of reaction, or it may be order of the reaction. For a particular instant of time, we have to draw a tangent at a time t in a concentration versus time graph. It is not possible to find what? No, that is instantaneous rate. That is now for every instant of time, it is a little bit difficult. So to avoid the problem or to solve the problem, we are going to what? No, integrate that differential rate equation. Differential rate equation, that is nothing but what? Instantaneous rate only. Integrated means what? No, differential rate means a particular interval of time only it is. For this, it is difficult to determine the rate as well as what? No, order of the reaction. So that we are integrating the differential rate equation. By integrating the differential rate equation, we can get what? No, what is the overall change for that reaction rate? In order to determine rate of a reaction, we usually integrate the differential rate equation. By integrating that gives what? No, the relation between the concentration of the reactants and the rate of the reaction as well as what? No, that rate constant, that gives some relation between concentration of the reactants and the rate constant. That is what is called a integrated rate equation. Following, all of you, integrated rate equation is we are integrating. Differential rate equation is different and integrated rate equation is different. Differential rate equation is applicable only for the instantaneous, right? Differential integrated rate equation is applicable for what? You know, that is overall reaction rate or at a particular interval of time. That is called differential rate, but it is not at a particular time interval. What is the overall rate change? That can be given by the relation that is called integrated rate equation. This gives the relation between what is it? Concentration of the reactants and rate constant. That is called what? Integrated rate equation. Okay, now let us take an example regarding what? No, integrated rate equation for zero order reaction. There will be one derivation regarding what? No, that integrated rate equation for a zero order reaction. It is nothing but what? No, derivation of rate constant of zero order reaction. It is derivation of rate constant of zero order reaction. Okay, now we'll go through the derivation here. First of all, let us consider the reaction. Let us consider the reaction in which now the reactant R is converted into product P. Is it not? Let us consider zero order reaction. You can take zero order reaction. zero order reaction. Just an example I'm telling you, R gives rise to P. Okay, now for this reaction, can you write down the differential rate equation for this? The differential rate equation is, what is it? Small d we have to write into bracket, that is change in concentration of reactant divided by what now? That is dt is equal to k into what is it now? Molar concentration of the reactant, or else we can write like this, dr by dt, the rate equation dr by dt is equal to k into molar concentration of r to the power 0. Following? What I am telling is here, dr by dt is equal to k into molar concentration of reactant, that is r to the power 0. This is the differential rate equation for zero order reaction. This is what is called now, rate is equal to, you can write like this also, what is that? Rate is equal to k into molar concentration of reactant r to the power 0. We can write like this also, you know, is it not? So what is that? Rate is equal to, differential rate is equal to what? D of r by dt is equal to k into molar concentration of the reactant. So we have to take this equation first of all. This is called what now? Differential rate equation for the zero order reaction. For any reaction you take, how to write the rate equation? Rate is equal to k into molar concentration of reactant, that is r naught only. So that accordingly, rate is equal to what now? That is differential rate means, that is instantaneous rate. Instantaneous rate, that is d of r by dt is equal to k into dt. That is concentration of the reactant decreases means, we have to mention what? Negative sign for this one. Negative sign, you know that already, significance of the positive negative sign. The reactant concentration always decreases during the progress of the reaction. We can write like this, dr by dt is equal to what now? That k into r naught. Now we can just simplify. What is it? D of r divided by dt is equal to k into 1, right? Anything to the power 0, that will be equal to 1 only. Or this will be equal to what now? That is minus. Minus d of r by dt is equal to k into 1. Or we can write like this also. Just take some steps in this manner. D of r divided by dt. Minus d of r by dt is equal to k into 1 only. Or this can be written as like this also. D of r is equal to minus k into dt also we can write. Is it not? Now this is one of the important equation, and here, you know, on integrating the above equation, this is very important one only, you should know that very well. Okay, integrate the above equation. First of all, you should know that minus d of r by dt is equal to k into 1. So on rearranging we get this equation. That is what? D of r is equal to minus k into dt. Integrate this equation. Then you can write like this also. On integrating, what we get? That is integration of d of r is equal to minus of integration of k into dt. This is what very important expression. We should know that very well. Integration of change in concentration of the reactant is equal to minus of integration of k into dt. Then on simplification you get like this. So integration of 1 into dx, just I am giving you one formula, integration of 1 into dx is equal to x only. Is it not? Integration of 1 into dx is equal to x only. It is dx only. 1 into dx is equal to what? That is x. So that you write now, instead of this one, d of r, you write now only r only. Then r is equal to what you write? Minus that is k into what is it now? dt will be written like this only, because 1 into dt, k you take the integration outside the integration k. in total that is one entity. You will get what of that? Integration of k into dt can be written as what? K into t only. This is plus I is the constant, integration constant. So here now I is called a constant. I is called a constant of integration. Constant of integration. You should know that carefully. Is it not? Okay, now here now to evaluate or to calculate the value of I, what we have to do? When time t is equal to 0, the concentration of the reactant R is equal to what now? That is R naught. Like this we can mention. Is it not? Before start of the reaction, we take what now? Time t is equal to 0 only. Then R will be equal to what? That is R naught. Means the concentration of the reactant is not changed. R naught means that is initial concentration. Capital R is called concentration of the reactant after the time interval t it is. Is it not? You should remember the point like this. Okay, now substitute the values here. Value of this R is equal to what? R naught is equal to minus K into 0 plus I. Okay. Then what is the value of I, you know? Then I is equal to R naught. So this is the value of the I. You substitute the value of I in this equation star, I can take. This is what is called equation star only. In the equation star, you substitute the value of I here. Following? Now we can take again. So capital R is equal to minus K into T, minus K into T plus R naught, minus K into T plus R naught. Or this can be written as K into T is equal to R naught, K into T is equal to R naught minus R. Or it may be K is equal to 1 by T into R naught minus R. R naught minus R. So this is what is called the integrated rate equation for the first order reaction. We should know that very well about this one, because it will be 3 marks or 4 marks question in the PUC level. You have to derive this integrated rate equation for the zero order reaction. Yes, listen, once again I am telling you, integrated rate equation for a zero order reaction. Or we are going to just determine what now? Rate constant for a zero order reaction. In order to find the rate constant of zero order reaction or integrated rate equation for the zero order reaction, let us consider the zero order reaction, that is R gives rise to P. For zero order reaction, how to write now the rate equation, can you tell me? This is what the rate equation, that is what R is equal to K into molar concentration of the reactant to the power 0, because this is zero order only. Okay, you take here this one. Rate is equal to what, you know? The differential rate equation is given by minus d of r by dt is equal to k into r naught. Okay, minus d of r by dt is equal to k into r naught only. Okay, now here now this you take here minus d of r by dt is equal to k into 1, because anything to the power 0 that will be equal to 1 only. And why we have to take the minus sign here? In the rate expression, if you take minus means the concentration of reactant decreases. Hence we take what now? Negative sign in case of the, that is rate equation. Okay, now here now on rearranging the equation, what we get? D of R is equal to minus K into dt we can get. Is it not? D of R is equal to minus K into dt. Now you integrate this equation. Integrate this equation. It can be written as like this. Integration of D of R is equal to minus of integration of K into dt. Is it not? Integration of d into r is equal to minus integration of k into dt. Now k is constant. You take this one outside, it will become what now? Like this also we can write here. So integration of dx or dr is equal to minus k into integration of 1 into dt. Like this also we can write. And after writing this one, you know that integration of 1 into dx is equal to x only. Then accordingly, integration of 1 into dr is equal to r only. Minus k only, as it is constant only. And into t, because 1 into dx, integration of 1 into dx is equal to x only, no? According to that, you write here. So integration of 1 into dt is equal to t only plus I, that is I is called a constant of integration. This you put the equation number star only. Now you see, I is called constant of integration. In the next step, what we have to do, you know, we have to find the value of I. How to find the value of I means just we have to take now, before start of the reaction,
the time t is equal to 0. When the time t is equal to 0, r is equal to r naught we take. R is equal to r naught means this r naught is the initial concentration. R is called concentration of the reactant after the time interval. And now you take here r naught is equal to minus k into 0 plus I. Then you are getting the value of I. What is the value of I? I is equal to r naught you are getting here. Is it not? Similarly, you take the substitute the value of I in that equation star. Substitute the value of I in the equation star. What is that equation star? R is equal to minus k into t plus r naught. This is the value of I only. And now you tell me kt is equal to r naught minus r. On rearranging, you are getting this equation. And finally, you can write k is equal to 1 by t into bracket initial concentration of reactant minus concentration after the time interval t, that is r naught minus r. So this is the final form of integrated rate equation for zero order reaction. This is what very important only, following all of you. Now here now, this is what is called kt is equal to r naught minus r. Even this equation can be written as r, that is molar concentration of the reactant, r is equal to molar concentration of the reactant, that is r is equal to, how to can write now, k minus k into t plus r naught, minus k into t plus r naught. So now this equation is similar to that of what, no, equation of the straight line, y is equal to minus mx plus c form only. So that you can plot a graph regarding this one. You can plot a graph. How to plot a graph? You see, you take no concentration of the reactant along the y axis you take, and then time t along x axis you take. Is it not? You are getting what, no, the negative slope in this graph. This is what is called a y intercept, or that is a c value, what is called, no, r naught. And remaining, what is it, no, the slope of this straight line is equal to what, you know, slope is equal to minus k. So in this way, the reactions which obey this equation, or this equation, they are all called what, no, zero order reactions. So in that way, you have to understand what is the concept of the zero order reaction. It is very important what I am telling you, very important. It is a 3 to 4 marks question definitely asking in the final examinations. You should know the derivation regarding that integrated rate equation for the reactions. Now this is what the integrated rate equation for the zero order reaction, or derivation of the rate constant for the zero order reaction, it is following. Should know very well about this one. Okay, next one more you can take, another one, what is called integrated rate equation for the first order reaction. Integrated rate equation for the first order reaction, same type only. We have to take what we discussed already in the case of the zero order reaction. The same type we have to study about the integrated rate equation for the first order reaction, or derivation of the rate constant k for the first order reaction. Here also the same thing I am telling you. Let us consider the first order reaction. Let us consider the first order reaction. Let us consider the first order reaction. What is that first order reaction? You see, that is what, no, reactant R is converted into the product P. Now here, no, the differential, or we can just write the rate equation for the reaction. The rate equation for the reaction, that is rate is equal to k into molar concentration of the reactant, that is r, we can take, following all of you. This is a rate equation for the reaction, and here r to the power 1. Why we have to take r to the power 1? As it is the first order reaction, we have to write now k into molar concentration of the reactant to the power 1 only. Okay, now we can take what is it? The differential rate equation for the reaction is, that can be written as change in the concentration of the reactant df r by dt. This is what, now, rate expression. For the rate expression, you can write like this. Rate is equal to what? Minus df r by dt. So this is equal to what, you know, k into molar concentration of the reactant, that is r only. Now you take here on rearranging the above equation. On rearranging the above equation, what do you get, you know? minus d of r divided by r is equal to k into dt. We can write is equal to k into dt. So this is what is called the differential rate equation for the first order reaction. Accordingly, on rearranging we get this one. This is what is called differential rate equation for the first order reaction. Now integrate the above equation. We can take integrate the above equation. Integrate the above equation. How to integrate this one, you know? Yes, now you tell me. Integration of minus d of r divided by d of r divided by r only. This is equal to integration of that is k outside the bracket. We take as constant of integration k into 1 into dt. We can take. This is what is called how to write in integrated form. Minus of d of r by r is equal to that is integration of minus d of r by r is equal to k into integration of 1 into dt. We can write as k is the constant. Okay, now just you can extend this one. We already know that integration of 1 into dx is equal to x only. 1 into dx is equal to x only. So that integration of minus d of r by dt, integration of minus d of r by dt is equal to that is ln r. We can write is equal to ln r. Is it not? Because here no integration of minus integration of minus r divided by or else 1 by r into or else integration of 1 by x into dx. Integration of minus 1 by x into dx is equal to ln x. So this is one of the formula given in the integration. Therefore, you can write now integration of minus 1 by x into dx is equal to ln x and integration of 1 into dx is equal to x. Okay, now you write here now integration of minus d of r by r is equal to ln r. This is equal to k into t plus I. We can write here I is called a constant. I is called a constant of integration. Constant of integration. Okay, this is what very important step. Based on this integration formula, we can just get this form. What is it? Ln r is equal to minus k into t plus I. Now to evaluate the value of I, we can take now concentration r is equal to r naught. We can take when the time t is equal to that is t naught, that is 0. We can take time t is equal to 0. Is it not? R is equal to r naught when time t is equal to 0. Before start of the reaction, time that is 0 we take, and the concentration of the reactant is taken as what, that is initial concentration, that is r naught only. Okay, now you tell me, you substitute this value here. Which one here? In this equation. This is what is called the equation number star only. You write as usual minus ln r naught is equal to k into t plus what is it now? Value of I is called what? That is what now? I only. And the value of t is equal to 0 only. So now here now k into 0 is equal to 0 or I is equal to minus ln r naught. So this is the value of I we have to take. Now substitute the value of I. Substitute the value of I in the equation star. Substitute the value of I in the equation star. Yes. Tell me now. What are you reading? Minus ln r is equal to k into t minus ln r naught. Minus ln r naught. It is the value of I only. Okay, now you tell me. On simplification, what you are getting? Okay. Now here, ln, or else write, kt is equal to ln r naught minus ln r. Kt is equal to ln r naught minus ln r. Or else write like this also, k is equal to 1 by t into ln of r naught divided by r, you can write ln of r naught by r. Okay, now here you tell me ln x is equal to 2.303 log x to the base 10 it is. Therefore k is equal to 2.303, okay, by t into log of r naught divided by r. So this is a final form of that equation. It is a final form of the equation. What is that final form? You know, k is equal to 2.303 by t into log of r naught by r. This is the integrated rate equation for the first order reaction. What is that? K is equal to 2.303 by t into log of r naught by r. K is called a constant, that is rate constant. T is called a time. R naught is called initial concentration of the reactants before start of the reaction it is, and R is called a concentration of the reactant after the time interval T. Even this expression you can also write like this. How it is written, you know, the expression can be written like this: K is equal to 2.303 divided by T into log of A divided by A minus X. You can write this is also first law, first order rate constant equation or integrated rate equation for the first order kinetics. 2.303 by T into log of A by A minus X. 2.303 by T into log of A by A minus X. Is it not? So now here, no, T is called time, K is called rate constant, small a is called initial concentration, A minus X is called concentration of reactant after the time interval T. So in this way, we can just write the equation. What is it? No, the integrated rate equation for the first order kinetics. This is very, very important. Yes, let us see once again. What is it? Let us consider the first order reaction, that is R to P. Write equation for the reaction like this: rate is equal to K into molar concentration of the reactant, that is R to the power 1, as it is first order kinetics. And this equation can be written as, what is it called? Differential rate equation for the reaction it is. If you use a small d, then it is called a differential rate equation only, or instantaneous rate only. D of R by dt is equal to K into R only. Is it not? On rearranging, we get like this: d of R by R minus d of R by R is equal to K into T, K into dt. On integrating this equation, you get what? No, integration of minus d of R by R is equal to minus K, and is equal to K into integration of 1 into dt. Is it not? Now we know the formula in the integration. Integration of 1 into dx is equal to x, or integration of minus 1 by x into dx is equal to ln x. Okay. Now here, no, minus ln r is equal to k into t plus i. This is equation star just to q. And then I is equal to constant of integration. Here it is. Then to evaluate the value of I, r is equal to r naught when time t is equal to 0. Before start of the reaction, the value of r means the reaction concentration is not changed. Just we take, no, r is equal to r naught. Similarly, minus ln r naught is equal to k into 0 plus I. Substitute the value of r and t in this equation, you get the value of I is equal to minus ln r naught. Substitute the value of I in this equation star, minus ln r is equal to, here it is minus ln r is equal to k into t plus value of I, that is minus ln r naught. Okay. Now here, no, on the rearranging, we get this one: kt is equal to minus ln r naught minus ln r. kt is equal to ln r naught minus ln r, ln r naught minus ln r. R, k is equal to 1 by t into ln of r naught by r. This is also one of the form of the integrated rate equation for the first order kinetics. This equation can be written like this: k is equal to 2.303 by t into log of r naught by r, because ln x is equal to 2.303 into log to the base 10 of x. So k is called rate constant, t is called time, here r naught initial concentration, and r is called concentration of the reactant left after the time interval. That is what r. This equation can also be written in this manner: k is equal to 2.303 by t into log of a by a minus x. Here small a is called initial concentration, and x is called concentration of the reactant reacted. So reacted here, a minus x means unreacted. So in that way, a minus x means the concentration of the reactant after the time interval t. So in this way, the rate equation or the integrated rate equation for the zero order as well as first order reaction given in this manner. These two derivations are very, 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 very important. You have to make practice number of times. By number of times, if you practice, then only you will be getting perfect, because it is most expected question in the chapter chemical kinetics. Hence, you have to understand and you derive on your own by means of practicing by number of times. Definitely out of these two, one question will be appearing in the final examinations. Hence you should go through this one carefully and learn it properly and perfectly, and you should know how to derive this one. Okay.